Okay, you guys, today we're going to talk about relationships. These are such key factors in our happiness. In fact, I recently watched a documentary called Happy that traveled the world looking at different cultures and occupations. And what they found that really amounted to the happiness that people had was their sense of community and the relationships where they felt like they were a part of something. So today we're going to talk about five things that you can do in your relationships to help you feel more freedom in them and avoid feeling stuck and enslaved by negative relationships. So the first thing is identity. You never want to change or lose your identity for the sake of a relationship. Relationships are based on authentic connection. So when you change who you are to try to impress somebody else, then it's really, you really don't get that same connection. And this is just as important for adults as it is with children. So when we see them trying to become something that they're not, we really want to be confident in who we are. And obviously we want to be with relationships that help us try to become better people, but not those that require us to change our core beliefs or core values or the core person who we are. The second thing that we want to look at is perspective. You really want to, anytime you're in a relationship and someone else has a different point of view than you, what I visually try to do is actually in my head switch places with the other person and practice trying to argue their point and see if I can find value in that. It's said that there's two kinds of people in the world, the ones you love and the ones you don't understand. In fact, that was a saying in my home when we grew up. And there's so much love and compassion that can come from understanding someone else's point of view. And I also look at, in a relationship when we're not seeing eye to eye, is the way that I'm treating them, motivating them to become better and find a solution with me, or is it deflating them to just not want to be around me? So it's more important how people feel around you than actually what they think about you. So take that into account when you're looking at your perspective. The third thing I want to talk about is just your boundaries. People will treat you the way that you teach them to treat you. And you are in charge of letting them know what's acceptable and what's not acceptable and creating those boundaries. Also making sure that you're respecting other people's boundaries. The less respect you show somebody else, the harder it is to expect them to show you respect. And this really includes gossiping and the way that they see you treat other people. The fourth thing I want to talk about is just closure. If you've got some, you know, painful relationships, you really want to take the time to heal those and do your part and then move on. Sometimes it means saying goodbye to a relationship that is pulling you down and not bringing you any joy in your life. Now, there will be some relationships that might be negative, but they're just a part of your life and there's no way to discontinue them. And so with those relationships, try to heal them as much as you can and think about what they have done to serve you. How have you grown or how have you learned from that relationship? And if you can take time to appreciate and love that person, then it will take a lot of the negative energy around it off of you. So I actually do an exercise where I hold my hands over my heart and I say, thank you, I love you, thank you, I love you, a couple times in my mind, obviously, so I don't sound like a crazy person, before I am interacting with them, because that really changes the whole energy around me and the energy that they feel when they're around me. So that helps our interactions be more positive. And then last, I want to talk about just love. I think that everything that we do is either an act of love or a cry for love. So whether it's the relationship between you and your spouse, you and a friend, maybe a coworker, or you and your child, sometimes they're really just seeking some extra love and compassion. And so for these relationships that are important to you, take the time to show them that love and care for them and come from a place of really respect. And then the last thing I want to say is just this peace blend that I love to use. Anytime I'm feeling less than peaceful in any of my relationships, I will put it on my reflex points, maybe in a diffuser, or maybe cup it in my hands and take a couple deep breaths. And if I'm going into a conversation, you know, where I have to talk to one of my kids about something or my husband, or I'm coming out of a conversation that I felt was tense, I know that I'm such a better mother, wife, mentor, friend when I'm coming from a place of peace and love. So hopefully today we can take some time to look at our relationships and just get them a little bit better. Thanks for joining me.